And welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is James McCormick, and this is your Moscow video session briefing, a video review of what we did in the live session at fxbootcamp.com.
Taking a look at the pound dollar today, we take a Fibonacci retracement study based off yesterday's trading range, and we can see that price has stopped around a 618 retracement. Now with the 618 retracement, that gives us an upside projection of a 1214 as primary or a 1382 extension level as potential targets. Now we also have news during the day coming up very soon, so we'll drop down to our 5-minute charts and treat this as a news trade and see how Fibonacci target levels come in with that. So here we are on the 5-minute chart. I've marked in the support and resistance of our first 5-minute candle. We like to give news items a 5-minute break that allows for any unnecessary whipsawing, enlarged spreads by brokers during news, etc. We like to give that price a bit of a time to sort that stuff out before we look at getting into a trade. Now we identify support and resistance and we look for a break thereof. Now the first 5-minute candle comes out, and to be honest, it's been quite a while since we've had a decent news item during the Moscow session. Looks a bit like a bit of a non-event here when we start to see that push up, then see a bit of red. But soon after, we start to see some reaction. Maybe it was a bit of a delayed reaction. Price continues on. Allow me to just move the charts. Price continues. And our first target is hit. This is the 1214 extension level of our 618 retracement of the previous day's range. Already there's 30 pips worth of movement. We've also broken through the 200 mark, and now this would be our first retest of the 200 mark. So that in itself is a viable entry. We've broken through the 200 mark. We've now retested it. We need to see it hold before entering in long. Our original trade is back here at 183 to break that resistance. The level is holding and price continues on. Price further reaches our secondary Fib target. One potential exit, two potential exits. At this stage, even on a 5-minute chart, we are seeing good angle and separation. Let's put this back to a 15-minute chart and see how it looks. Here we are on the 15-minute chart. You can see the lines I've drawn for support and resistance on the first 5-minute candle. You can see it continue out. A retrace of the 5 on a 15-minute level occurred to provide perhaps a later news entry. You can see that retrace to the 200 mark there that we were looking at on a 5-minute chart. And at this stage, on a 5-minute chart, you probably were wondering why would we shoot for the secondary target when we had our primary one there. Well, let's take a look at the angle and separation in the 5-8. Gaining angle and separation as it goes. 21 and 55 as well. Now you'll also notice that if we move our charts around a little bit, now it's an hourly one and it's given it away a little bit at the moment. I've also marked it here on the 15-minute. That we had M4 not too far above that. Now it's a judgment call you need to make with your trades. Will you get out at the conservative target, the slightly more aggressive target, or seeing that M4 was an overlay of Fibonacci extensions, two different parties coming together to look at the same level, making it all that more important to perhaps have as an overall aggressive target. And in this particular day, all three levels were reached with the total maximum pips. Remember, we got in about 83. Not quite an exact 60 pip movement. Quadruple MAP. MAP we call minimal acceptable performance, and we lock that in at 15 pips. Very successful day for some of our traders. Congratulations to them. I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope the information within it has been clear for you. I look forward to seeing you in tomorrow's session of the Moscow video. Again, I would like to apologize for not putting up any videos the last few days. I have been feeling unwell with a bit of a cold. Feeling much better now. Thank you all for your patience, and I wish you good luck with the markets. Certainly plenty of money out there for us all to profit off. Enjoy, and I'll catch you tomorrow.